All right, so we're going to take a few minutes to go over the FTP process and make sure you understand how to FTP your project. Before you begin this, you're going to need to make sure you've watched or you understand how to set your files up for FTP. So you should have your images optimized and you should have an HTML page that basically will load your images so that we can critique them. So before that, let's go over, we've got a website set up for our web design classes, and each faculty member has a page for their class that they've set up with an area for each student to FTP. So we've done a lot of the work behind the scenes to set up your area on the Web Studio. And so basically from there, we've got to go through the process of how we FTP. So basically we've got this space set up for you guys. Everybody has their own login. If you have your files ready to FTP, you're just going to open an FTP program. We use Fetch on campus. It's pretty easy. It's a great program for Macintosh. There are a lot of others for other platforms. I know FileZilla and CyberDuck, and there's a few others. I think Smart FTP is another one that a lot of students use. They're all free. They're very similar. A lot of them are pretty easy to use in the beginning, but if you've never FTP'd before, it might seem a little overwhelming. So when you first log in, it's going to open this window that asks for your login information. So the host name is our website. It's so easy to make typos, so make sure you've typed everything correct. Your username is going to be your last name, and I've got basically a demo account for us, and then at valenciawebstudio.com. And then your password is going to be provided to you by your professor. Same thing with the username. Depending on if you're taking another web class, your faculty that's teaching you is going to make sure that you're given your login information. So you're going to want to make sure that you have the correct login. Usually the biggest error students make is typing it incorrectly. You want to make sure that you're using all lowercase, no spaces, and no special characters with all naming on the web. In this case, the username, our host actually requires us to use at valenciawebstudio.com. So that is a part of your username if you're taking classes here. So we're going to go ahead and connect. Once you connect, you'll see that there's folders already set up for you, usually, especially in the beginning level web design course. So depending on what you're working on, if you're working on an exercise, there's a folder for every exercise. It's a good way to give you practice FTPing. And then we've got one for each project. So basically, we've set this space up, and if you go back to the Web Studio, every single one of these links is already pre-set up for you so that if you upload to the correct place, it should work. So we're going to go ahead and double click on project one. And then what I'm going to do is, instead of taking this folder that's called FTP demo, I'm going to take the contents of the folder and I'm just going to drag and drop them over. Now when you FTP, it is specifically looking for a file called index.html. It's just something specific that servers look for as the kind of like the home page. So if you've named your file anything other than that, or if you've capitalized it, it's probably not going to load correctly. We've linked specifically to the folder so that it would look for this file. So if you have everything uploaded, the best way to test it is to go to the website then and then just click on your name. So we've got one here for demo student, and there's our project. Okay, and so on critique day, this is going to make it a lot easier for us to go through. We don't expect you to have multiple pages linked to one another to present things. Just keep it all on one page, keep it simple. Again, if you're stuck on how to set up your files, we do have another screencast for that, so make sure you watch it. If you're having troubles FTPing, the number one thing that students do incorrectly is they log in with the incorrect login information. So always double check and make sure that you've typed it correctly. If you try it a couple times and it still continues not to work, make sure you're paying attention to that error message. If it says your login is incorrect, you've probably messed up the login information and you're not typing it correctly. But if you're having troubles, we would rather you contact us and let us know, hey, it's not working, so we can help you. If you try to log in more than, I think, 10 times, the server does lock your IP address because it thinks maybe you're trying to hack into our server. The other thing to know is that you do have a limited amount of space. Your teacher will tell you the amount of space you're limited to. If you go over what that space limitation is and you post too many files, it may actually limit how much can go up to the server. So if you go over your quota, it may actually give you an error saying you've exceeded your limitation. So if that pops up, just contact us, let us know. A lot of the times, you're going to be the one that has to go back and make sure you're optimizing your files and make sure that you don't have too big of files on the web studio. When you're FTPing, you want to make sure that all of your images are meant for the web. So HTML files, and then things like JPEGs. You don't want to post PSD files, you don't want to post Illustrator files, and you don't want to post your large process books. Those usually get posted to Blackboard. So hopefully that helps you guys out in FTPing. Again, if you're running into troubles, do your best to troubleshoot, but if you're still having trouble, contact your professor and let them know and see if we can help you guys work through the challenges FTPing.